Hello there, beautiful Minecraft addicts! I've been playing for quite some time now on a server, so on multiplayer. This is the spawn point. Now this server is of course administered, how do you say, managed by Eq, okay, I have a tough time pronouncing his name. Eqvaliser, I think that's it, yeah. So maybe you've seen some of his videos. It's actually quite a nice feeling to be able to walk in the footsteps of the man and actually see in live what he has recorded in his videos. So this is the beginner's road. Don't worry about that for now, I'll explain later. Of course, my texture pack, my modified texture pack. Now this is main portal area, as you can see in the bottom left corner. Let's see what we have here. Stronghold, this should be EQ's, yeah, viewpoint. And yeah, this is the a portal to some of the public areas on the server. I'm not going to go into these right now because you've seen most of them in EQ's videos. So yeah. What I want, why I did this video, is because I wanted to. I've gotten pretty far with my build, and I'm not sure how much I can stay on this server because I have quite a lot of work to do, and I'm thinking maybe just a little bit tone down my Minecraft playing. Now I know I haven't been making many videos lately, but concerning the Minecraft play, it's been a lot. A lot, yeah. So let's go at our home, that is about 500 blocks that way. Okay, let's see if we are lucky and it loads. And of course it doesn't load, let me just get right back. Okay, and we are back. The section of the map, because it's so far, it's it takes a little while to load into my memory, and that's why I have this chunk errors. Let's get outside and start the tour with the exterior. This is basically my hill. The spawn point is that way. Yeah, and I wanted to build more of a natural looking, how do you say, home. It's actually quite homey. So this is my unfinished solar flower, only 8 solar panels over there. Okay, a small lake. Let's go downstairs. This is my main depositing area, and as you can see here, I have my dust, nickelite, gunpowder, redstone, and glowstone. Here I have all my unprocessed ores. Yeah, this is some of my processed ores. Automatic crafting table, alloy furnace from red power, and these are also from red power, some furnaces, blue electric furnaces, and that's the battery box. Now EQ said we should use them, these furnaces, quite a lot. I mean, he uses them quite a lot, and I've tried using them, but unfortunately, I don't know why is it, I use them for charcoal production, and yeah, they're not quite, I don't know. I mean, electric furnaces are much better, in my opinion, in my humble opinion, of course. What else? This is of course the green area and the mob, what do you call it, all the vanilla Minecraft stuff, all the mod stuff, okay, and some other stuff. Of course, here we have the main industrial area, okay, bat box, some macerators, furnaces, extractor, compressor, I would say compactor, and a recycler. This is a small system I made for the recycler. This timer takes every, let's put it 2 seconds. Yeah, when I don't use it, I just like to do like that. So I put all my junk in here. It all it gets pulled out by this transposer, gets into the recycler. And from the recycler with this engine here gets into that. So basically it's a combination of red power and Buidcraft to power these guys. Here, whoa, what is that? Just a second, okay. Here, this room is actually in construction. I am going to build here if I get to it. Whatchamacallit, a cobblestone generator. It's a kind of late to build one, but if I want to have enough scrap to power my mass fabricator, I'll need a big production line for scrap. So yeah. Okay, one next. Yeah, let's go to outside and see my mob farm, shall we? Oh no, it's raining. It's raining zombies. Yeah. I think this server is on normal or hard with the mobs, because I've been having... Oh, let me just get it day and stop raining and I'll be right back. Okay guys, so we're back. I'm all alone on the server, that's why I can make it day. So this is my mob farm. It started as a usual drop mob farm, and it's basically a plus sign, a huge plus sign with why don't I just show you from beneath, a huge plus sign with water that all the water collects from the edges, and that's a 2x2 gap, and all the mobs drop down from there onto this platform. These are of course transposers that collect all the drops. I think they're on a 1 minute interval. Let's just make sure that's okay. I really love this. Is that on 1 minute? Yeah, 60 seconds. Actually, a zombie died. Maybe we'll get lucky and see the process. I don't remember where it is. Oh, it's halfway there. Anyway, these are red power redstone tubes. So that impulse from the timer gets transmitted to the tubes, and they power all the things necessary. Let me just get this over here. I really wanted to build that stair because I saw it in one of CNB's Minecraft tutorials, 60-second tutorial. And and of course the skeleton dropped, and at the same time the stuff was collected. Actually, let's look into in the box, shall we? In the chest. So yeah, as you can see, there are a lot of stuff in here. Nice stuff. Won't be concerned for now with that. I think, yeah, my speed potion. There it goes. The server is a little bit laggy. It doesn't have a lot of RAM or processing power. We are actually on a 8-player cap. Yeah, but when we are even three players, if there are enough machinery around, the server actually kicks us out, and it's kind of annoying. But when I'm alone on the server, it's really smooth and fun. Yeah. So yeah, this is the drop farm, as I was saying. Now, besides doing a standard farm, I wanted to be able to make some Enderman pearls, and I devised an entire system just for that. But unfortunately, I don't get any Ender pearls. I mean, the system isn't. I wanted to be able to kill Enderman with Tesla coils, and that's why I have 4 Tesla coils. Let me just close this for now, just not to get harmed. So here we have, of course, solar panels. 4 solar panels, each solar panel on a bat box, and underneath each bat box there is a Tesla coil that gets discharged by this red power wire. And of course, this is on a timer of 2.5 minutes. And I was thinking 2.5 minutes because it has to work 3 times a day or so. So that was my my thinking, but I don't know, it really doesn't work. There is a lot of work put into this system, of course. As you can see, there are a lot of transporters here that collect all the material after the mobs are killed, but I don't know, it doesn't work as intended. Okay, what next? Okay, this is my farm. This farm isn't automated at all. It's a simple wheat farm with some reeds from flax from red power and pumpkin. I like to use a lot of pumpkin for lanterns. So yeah, basically this is my preferred setup of a farm. I have a center row that's actually filled with water beneath, and that water is enough to make 1, 2, 3, 4 rows of watered tilled soil. Yeah. So yeah, and you basically do this as long as you want and just fill the middle row with water. Now here, this is actually not quite that important, but I wanted to show you guys. What I have here is apparently Enderman Griefer, because that wasn't supposed to be there. Oh, there it is. Yeah, this is my flower collection area, sort of say. Okay, I basically turn off the lights. It's not automated because I don't use it very often, just for yeah. And this guy over here powers a deployer underneath the floor that spams the floor with bone meal, and because it's pitch dark, all the almost all the stuff on the floor gets automated automatically. Man, this was quite a griefer. Maybe I have to do this too high from now on. Just as a heads up. Yeah. And this is of course standard a standard concept for this kind of seed farms. Okay, next, this area over here, I wanted it to be a wood farm. somewhat of an automated wood farm. It's a lot of work. It's a really big chunk of work, and it's still a work in progress, but maybe I'll get to it, maybe not. We'll see. So basically we have a quarry over there that's powered through this power pipes, golden power pipes, and all the things that get collected go through here. Here we have 5 solar panels from Red Power, and apparently they can get the solar through glass blocks, which is nice. I wanted to do that. Okay, let's get inside. Whoa. This is the engine room for the quarry. Now we don't need as many engines. I just went overboard. There are 7 engines here. We just need maybe 3 of them. So basically what happens, this quarry collects goes through this pipe. So yellow on yellow goes only wood, okay, which gets into this chest, and these transposers, this Red Power setup, okay, with the battery box, and we have a furnace here and 2 transposers. Okay, so wood gets from there into this furnace, and charcoal gets out through the floor and into these steam engines. Of course, the system is built in such a way that the first steam engine gets full of charcoal, then the second one, and so on and so forth till the end. Okay, that's a timer for these transposers to go off, I think, you know, 7 seconds interval. And here is a collection for all the other stuff like saplings, rubber wood, and some other stuff. Okay, why don't I just maybe show you. Okay, and we have some bone on us, which is good. Do I have anything in this chest? No, we haven't. Let's just show you how this quarry works real quickly now. Okay, so maybe one over here, one over here. Alright. I've always dream of getting this big tree oaks under a quarry like this, but it never happens. Okay, so we have those trees. Now we'll power the quarry. Okay, apparently this one doesn't have any charcoal, no worries. Now this line over here is powered. Okay, let's see the quarry in action in just a little bit. Oh, let me just make it day again and I'll be right back. Okay guys, so the quarry is now powered. Hello little fellow. The quarry ends exactly in this spot over here where I've built a cobblestone generator setup. That's because I don't want the quarry to start digging the the dirt around it. So yeah, so the quarry does its job, okay, and when it finishes it always gets this cobblestone over here. The thing is, because this have it has 7 engines powering it, it actually draws a little line, so this cobblestone generator needs to be a little bit longer or a little bit less engines. Okay, and when this cobblestone here gets picked up, I don't know if you can see there, but there is a redstone torch over there which powers this redstone dust. Okay, and when that cobblestone gets picked up, it basically sends a signal, it basically unpowers this redstone. Let's just do that for now. Okay, so that got powered off and now again powered on. This will go on for just a little bit more, because as I said there is a lot of energy in it. Okay, and let's see what happens when that redstone gets turned off. We basically will follow this line over here, okay? Don't worry about this. This is the mechanism for the doors that I showed you earlier. The doors, the stairs. It's separated by the with some glass panes from this other line. This is a latch some sort. RS latch, okay, so basically this gets powered on this part by that redstone getting powered off, and that means the engines stop. That's as simple as it gets. So an RS latch, and here we have a NOT gate just to invert the signal. That's it. That's all you need. Okay, this can be actually done without red power. It can be done only with Buidcraft if you want it. Now, in order to this block over here with grass is what supports that redstone dust. Okay, so in order to get the power, In order to get that that power, you need the repeater over here because it doesn't get transmitted any other way. So that's an inverter. This of course doesn't matter if the redstone dust gets powered again, because the RS latch is already powered on this part of the line. So that's about it for automation on this quarry. What else do I have? Maybe I do downstairs. Okay, let's walk through here. This shaft over here goes upstairs to my main base area, but for now we'll get downstairs, and just for now. Whee! This is a quick way to get down. Unfortunately, it sometimes kills you. I don't know why. Do I have a minecart over here? Oh, darn it. Let me just get a minecart and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, so I got a minecart. As you can see, to the public XP farm. Now the design of this farm wasn't there's a skeleton down there. The design of the XP farm wasn't made by me, the farm itself. I just helped a little bit with the room, because initially it was a very cramped room. Don't worry, that's just stuck like that. Yeah, I made these doors. I always as you know, I always like to make this kind of doors. Red power helps a little bit, not much, but it does help. So welcome to the public XP farm. It's a simple XP farm. There is a zombie spawner over there. They drop from quite a height in here, and they are being kept in place by those slabs. You just stand in here and kill them as much as you want. This I think is a public chest. Yeah, I put that there and removed. The server allows for private chests, so you have to remove your how do you call it? I don't know how it calls. So you have to make it public. It doesn't automatically go public. Okay, so let's get a little bit further here. We'll travel now to a portal, another portal. Now the reason why I did another portal so far from the spawn point being quite a long way that way. Actually, let me just waypoints. There should be a spawn point over here. I know it's here, but I just can't see it. Well, this should maybe indicate some sort of direction. Now there is I don't know if you could see at the beginning of the video, there was a portal, and that's actually near that blue spot, which is 1,000 blocks away. That's another portal gate, and it seems that whatever I did, whatever portal I did, it always seemed to get back to the same portal in the overworld, and also in the Nether. So I had to go a long way to just make another spawn point for my portal. Welcome to the Nether. Okay, this is not much developed. This is a Netherworld farm. I like to build things like farms, just a little bit. I like to go just a little bit overboard, but not much. As you can see, there are a lot of. You can sit here for maybe 10 minutes going AFK, and you'll get a lot of Nether wards. Okay, this is a bridge that I built to go to a blaze spawn that I haven't just got around to doing. Maybe I will show that in the finishing part. Now, this over here is a setup I built for a mass fabricator. Okay, it is a little bit buggy because I don't know. I don't understand the physics of how energy is transmitted from this MFE to the mass fabricator. It should get 128 EUs per tick, but it doesn't. It gets a lot less. So something's burning. I don't have no idea what. Yeah, so basically we have a pump over here that's powered by four redstone engines. It's in the middle of a lava lake. Okay, that lava gets into that lava tank. Okay, through here. This is of course some little bit of red power wiring just to enable some automation. Alright, and here we have like this, we have a deployer that automatically fills empty buckets with lava from the tank. This is a filter that automatically sucks out from the deployer only lava buckets. It sends them in the nearest empty slot. Okay, it's so basically if there is no lava bucket in here, it sends that lava bucket in there. After that lava bucket is emptied, and it becomes empty, of course, this is a retriever which only retrieves empty buckets and puts them back in the deployer, and the cycle repeats itself over and over and over. This is of course a battery box from Red Power in order to power this retriever. Now I brought Red Power energy in here through batteries. That's I think the a nice feature Eloran implemented in I'm pre-release C maybe, if I'm not mistaken. Now this of course is the red power part, so the energy gets into this MFE, and when is energy is getting into the MFE, this detector powers that redstone that basically powers all the other stuff with the automation process that I was talking about. It powers this section over here and also the redstone engines over there. So that redstone dust over here is very, very important. This is of course another public chest. Crafting table, that's a private chest of mine because I pulled out some of this tubing over here and I just wanted to have that in hand in case I need them. Okay, let's go to the blaze farm and be right. I just realized that I called it a blaze farm when it's actually a blaze spawner because I haven't worked on it at all. I really like this bridge. It took quite a lot of materials and time, but hey, when it's nice, it's nice. Okay, the blaze spawner should be right here somewhere if I'm not mistaken. Maybe the second on the left. I have a fire resistance potion on me. No? It should be right over here somewhere. Oh yeah, gust. Oh, there it is. Alright, so this is the blaze spawner. Quite your standard blaze spawner, nothing. I'm thinking about automating the process, of course. From what I understand, we have I have a guy on the server here called Superminer. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Guys! Yeah, that's it. You can put fire on me, but not... Come on. Be nice, be nice. Yeah, there you go. Let's get out of here for now. So I was talking about a player on the server, Superminer. He's quite a tech whiz with this kind of stuff, and he actually showed me a quite simple concept with a blaze spawner. You encase the blaze spawner in 11 by 11 and a 2 high cobblestone slab, if you will. So that basically stops the spawner from spawning. And I was thinking maybe doing something with sticky pistons, because I don't really need the blaze farm to be an experience farm. I just need it for the blaze rods. So that should be nice. Okay, so this is it, I think. Maybe some other small stuff, but not very important. Let's just end this video on a more greener setup, so I'll be right back. Okay, crafters, so this is the train station. I think this would be a nice ending to the video. This is already par for going to the desert village. Okay. So let's see how this goes. There should be a cart arriving here. Okay. Press to launch. And we just wait and see what happens. There's going to be, of course, some lag. Maybe, I don't know, turn my videos to normal. This is going to kill my computer, of course, but I want you to be able to see a little bit more. I like this this part of the track, because there are a few guys that build their houses quite near to the spawn, and of course quite near to this track, and that's Superminer's place. It's initial place from what I remember. He's he likes to wander a lot. To I don't know, he's actually have he has some mines right next to my place. Whoa, 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 whoa. Darn it. Yeah, this part of the what happened? Oh yeah, I had another cart. Oh crap. And now of course I can't get out of here, because I need to put a password, so I'll be right back. Alright, so I got out of the train station. I really like this this small concept. The problem with this with it is that when you come from over there with such a high speed, this this line over here isn't enough to stop you, so you go through the wall. It's quite annoying, but what do you want? These guys apparently built a lot of things over here. This is the desert city. What the hell did they build over here? Alec. Alec's place. Okay, let's see. I haven't been here for quite some time. Payment, industrial credits, super miners, shop of stuff, desert city, static build, status building closed, payment expensive potions 40 credits. This chest is locked with a magical spell. Another brick and fence. $25 credits. I don't get it. It should be. He should have made some industrial craft. Whatchamacallem? Shop or something. Anyway. So, yeah. This is my place. I didn't make it. I just went ahead and put some lanterns. As you can see, I like to build with a lot of lanterns. This is Armani's place. Now he's quite a freakish dude with details, and he actually builds on a very, very large scale. I mean, he doesn't kid around. What is this? Materials from Armani for free using. Nice. Slabs. Oh, and a little bit of lag we have over here. Whoa, 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 whoa. That's a lot of brick, basalt brick. That's nice. Oh, and apparently there is a village nearby, because I see a villager. Anyway, so this is Armani's place. Let's go visit it. Man, this guy is crazy. Now, I'm not saying that it's a bad thing, because I love what he does, but I never would have dreamt of building on such a large scale. I know it's Buildcraft and industrial craft and industrial mods, but for me that's way too much. I mean, whoa. Yeah. All right. And this apparently is some netherrack over here. He has a small fireplace. Okay, let's go downstairs. Whoa. And he apparently has more layers. Whoa, come on, come on. So yeah, this is one layer of one floor. Whoa. Oh yeah, and this is apparently some sort of underground, under the city. Underground area, maybe for some industrial craft cabling, I think. So this should be handy if we ever want to make a sewage system in this place, if. Okay, let's go in here. This is apparently a work in progress. Yeah. Okay. Pum, 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 pum. What else? Oh yeah, this is supposed to be some sort of a public house, a public meeting place. This is Perez place, Pere 250, I think, and I think yeah. The player is actually a girl, which is kind of nice to have a. Oh, and yeah, she did wood paneling on all the house. This is why I was talking that a girl is good for the game, because it brings a nice touch, some nice aesthetics, maybe a different kind of building altogether. But I got to hand it to Armani. He's the boss. Yeah. Well, that's it for now. It's been quite a nice gameplay on this server. I really liked it. I really like it a lot. Apparently, the server will go to 1.1 quite soon, as the bucket versions of the mod are up to date. So maybe we'll see you then. Don't forget to be awesome, guys. Ciao.